Carla, we're good. We're saying good morning.
You're ready? Good morning, everyone. My name is Carla Cuerva.
My name is Luis Acuña.
And welcome to the third and last day of the 7th Asia-Pacific Occupational Therapy Congress. As of today's count, we have a total of 903 delegates across 22 countries, 686 of whom are professionals and 216 are students. This represents the biggest attendance recorded for the APOTC. So bravo. And again, we welcome you all.
To recap yesterday's events, we had the keynote address by architects Joseph Kwan and Tony Wong. We also had the Professor Tsuyoshi Sato Memorial Lecture of Dr. Athena Yinjung Chai. We've had concurrent sessions for medical conditions and the COVID-19 pandemic, occupational therapy in schools, and a roundtable discussion on transitions in occupation. We had a few more. Oh, wait, did we just go live? Or was that a delay on my part?
Go on, you're good.
Okay. Are we sure? I think we might have started without everyone knowing. Can we have a reaction from the audience if you caught everything we've said so far? Yes, thank you. That's awesome. All right, going back. We had a few more for assistive technology with children and children's gadget use, sustainability, work, employment, and mental health.
Today, we have several impressive keynote speakers, as well as a plenary session in the afternoon. Topics in our concurrent sessions will be on pediatrics, research, older persons, assistive technology, and a workshop on interventions for visual impairment. All oral presentations in parallel sessions will be in the morning, so please take note of the rooms of the sessions that you would like to join. Here, our platform, AirMeet, is best experienced using a desktop or laptop device. Kindly avoid having two devices running at the same time. If you're having difficulty with connectivity, try refreshing your browser. And if audio is low, try adjusting your device's volume controls. Best if you have a headset as well.
Well, before we go on, we also would like to thank our sponsors for supporting our Congress. We can't give the details of them, but briefly, they are Learning Ablers, the Japanese Association of Occupational Therapists, Chiang Mai University Occupational Therapy Department, One World Connect, Gold Plan Insurance Services, Therapy Works Inc., GOALS, AI Abilities and Intelligences Therapy Center, Play Plus Therapy Center, Academy for Able Children with Exceptionalities, Center for Habits, Palawan Special Consumers Cooperative, and JST Private Resort.
We are also inviting all our delegates and speakers to explore the AirMeet platform. Please visit the lounge where you are able to join and sit at tables and converse and network with colleagues. Visit the booths to view more poster presentations and learn more about our sponsors. These tabs are located next to the schedule tab on the top of this page. The lounge is always open for some small group discussion. We would now like to welcome back Dr. Anthony Gresha, President of the Philippine Academy of Occupational Therapists, to introduce our keynote speaker for this morning.
Good morning. It is my honor to introduce our guest speaker this morning. Our guest speaker is currently the president of the Japanese Association of Occupational Therapists, as well as its delegate to the World Federation of Occupational Therapists. He has more than four decades of experience as a practitioner, manager, author, and leader of organizations inside and outside occupational therapy. He is currently the director or trustee of several organizations, including the Japan Council of Rehabilitation Education, Japan International Medical Technology Foundation, Japanese Society for the Rehabilitation of Persons with Disabilities, Japan Stroke Association, Japan Association of Home Visit Rehabilitation, and Rehabilitation Schools Association, among others. Our keynote speaker has also written books and resources for cerebral palsy, prosthesis, musculoskeletal disorders, and diabetes mellitus. He is also an awardee of the Japanese Ministry of Health, Labor, and Welfare. It is my honor to introduce our keynote speaker. He is the president of one of the most supportive associations to the Philippine Academy of OT. So without further ado, let's welcome Mr. Haruki Nakamura. Thank you.
I'd also like to express my deepest respect to the Philippine Academy of Occupational Therapists and their members for their efforts to host this Congress. And I, on behalf of JOT, would like to thank for this opportunity. First, I will be reporting on what JOT can do for the strengthening of collaboration among occupational therapists in the Asia-Pacific region and initiatives and achievements of MTDLP.
の成果についてご報告をいたします。まず JOT について概要をご報告したいと思います。日本は極東の小さな島国であります。
First, I provide an overview of JOT.
世界一の
Japan is a small island country.
現在
高齢化率が30%、
少子高齢化。
Its people have the longest lifespan of any nation.But the country's aging rate has reached around 30%. It consists of 47 prefectures. The JOT office is located in Tokyo, near the center of Japan. APOTC 2024 will be held in Sapporo.
札幌の名所でございます。ぜひご参加をお待ちしております。東京にあります事務局を少しご紹介いたします。これは三社祭りといいまして、毎年5月に開催されますが、日本でも有名なお祭りでございます。近くには日本で一番
人工
の建物が高いスカイツリーがあります。
Adjacent to the Sensoji Temple and the Sumida River Park. These sports are venues for events such as the Sanjo Festival, so you can enjoy sightseeing in any season.
とても有名な川でありまして、このように遊覧船も運行しております。これは浅草寺というお寺でございます。このような近隣のこの近くにありますのが、我が日本作業療法 JOT の事務所であります。この中の2階、
Our office is housed in the second, third, and seventh floors of this building and is operated by 20 employees, including 6 of them.
20人で協会は運営をしております。今から少し作業療法士に JOT の作業療法についてのお話をいたします。スライドのこの右側にはですね、
The slide shows the areas of employment of JOT members. The main target diseases. As of September 2021, there were 63,498 members, of which 61.4% were women and 38.6% were men. From a global perspective, I think the ratio of men is quite high. The average age is 35.6 years old.By the way, the average age of Japanese doctors is 47 years old, which makes it relatively young. The area of employment is shown on the right side of the figure. Blue indicates medical care, and gray represents long-term care. And about 80% of the members are currently working in these areas.
世界的に見ますと、
I think this is one of the major characteristics unique to JLT.
平均年齢
は 35.6
歳。ちなみに、医師の平均年
齢は約 47 歳です。
まあ、集団としましては比較的若い集団と言えます。左の、
The bar graph on the left shows the main target diseases.
介護保険関係に勤めている作業療法士の主たる
We are developing occupational therapy for various diseases such as brain, circulatory system, locomotor system, mental disorder, developmental disorder, frailty, and cancer.
身体障害、発達障害等々に人を担当しているということになっております。まあ、一番多いのが脳卒中関係だということになります。この図は日本の社会保障制度
の作業療法士がどのような領域で勤務しているかを示しています。先ほど医療保険、介護保険と話をしました。
医療保険、介護保険
と話をしました。その上の2つが、ここからこれが介護保険の領域であります。Followed by medical care, long-term care, health and education.
それから障害
者の方の福祉の方。Below that, there are welfare and labor relations.And each legal system is listed on the right side. As I will explain later, occupational therapy in Japan is positioned within the medical system. But as shown here, therapist's field of activity is expanding in line with the needs of society.
この図は年齢 5歳別のですね、10歳別の年齢構成を見たものです。注目していただきたいのは、
This slide shows the membership ratio. About 40% are under 30 years old. And the current state of lifelong education for this young generation is a major issue.
障害教育をどうするかということが一つの大きな課題になっております。この図は発想
を JOT ができ
ましてから現在までの
Light blue represents that of qualified partners. And dark blue represents the change in the number of JOT members. As of April 2021, there are 104,286 qualified partners, 63,250 members.And a membership rate of approximately 61%. Last year, the enrollment rate dropped due to COVID-19. There are 198 training schools, 209 courses, with a student capacity of 7,820. The number of births in Japan in 2020 was 880,000.And by 2040, it will be less than 800,000, which is less than the enrollment capacity of universities. And the error in which university enrollment capacity outnumber university applicants will come anytime soon.Obtaining students who aim to become occupational therapists is one of the major issues.
On this
slide, the circle on the left shows the ratio of universities and vocational schools, and the four and three-year systems. Around 63% are trained on a four-year system. Training in university education is 38%. The table on the right shows a percentage of universities by the establishment and the number of master's and doctoral programs. There are 8 universities, about half of which have a master's program, and 75% of which have a doctoral program. Fostering and organizing occupational therapy academia is also an issue. In 2020, the curriculum of training school was revised for the first time in 30 years, and the total number of credits was changed from 93 to 101, with a focus on developing human resources that contribute to comprehensive community care. At the same time, discussions have been held on the current regulations for the three-year system. And it has been decided that the amendment in 2025 will consider a four-year system or longer. As previously mentioned, considering the declining birth rate and the structure of Japan's educational background, I think the university education must be 4 years or longer.
この表はですね、日本の定義を示しています。
As mentioned before, many of JLT members are engaged in medical and long-term care. However, the family law has a lot to do with this in the background. The table shows the contents of the PT and OT Act passed in 1965.Which positions PT and OT within the medical zone. It clearly states that occupational therapy should be performed under the instruction of a doctor. This law has been implemented since with little to no revision. As a result, most occupational therapists are in the medical field. The notice in yellow was issued by the Director General of Medical Affairs in 2010 to clarify the term occupation in the law.And contains almost all the details of occupational therapy in hospitals. Medical fees in Japan are revised every 2 years, and occupational therapy is included in most of them. In 2018, occupational therapy for IADL outside of medical facilities was added to the fees.Expanding the range of activities of occupational therapists. It took more than 10 years to achieve this system. But many professionals have acknowledged that JLT's activities have contributed significantly.
そのような中で、1966年にできました法律で、に我が国の作業療法は実施していたわけですが、ここに書いてあります通りですが、脳卒中等の方が在宅に帰ってからそれをどうフォローするかということが非常に課題になりました。そうしましたら定義にあります身体障害及び精神障害で病院である
という As shown in the previous slide, support for activities and participation is expanding in medical care as well.However, JLT established the definition of occupational therapy in 1985, taking the fact that the OT stipulated in the Medical Care Act should be used only for the medical treatment and should meet many needs of society into account. In addition to persons with physical and mental disabilities,The target of occupational therapy has been expanded to people who are expected to develop these disabilities with the purpose of acquiring an independent life. Under this definition, we have been performing occupational therapy in the fields of health and welfare.
Furthermore,
the long-term care insurance law, which was established in 2000, has a basic principle of guaranteeing dignity and human rights and aiming for an autonomous and independent life. Once again, the use of occupational therapists outside of medical care is being developed within the legal system.
広げさせていただきました。人々の健康と幸福のために作業療法を対象とする人、場所は関係なくあらゆる人にアプローチしようではないかというふうなメッセージであります。その他に作業というのをもう少し分かりやすく説明しようということで注釈をつけました。
In 2018, for the first time in 33 years, the definition by JOT was revised to that on the slide. This revision was influenced by the global trend in occupational therapy. The transformation of Japanese society into a community-based society and the contribution to the comprehensive community system. The new definition now includes all citizens regardless of disease and disability and aims to promote a happy and healthy life.Furthermore, five annotations were added to help people further understand what occupational therapy is. First, it should be based on academic evidence. Second, it should target people who have difficulty in performing occupations and people and groups who were expected to experience difficulty.The third annotation explained the content included in the occupation. The fourth highlights the importance of independent and individual goals and values. Finally, it mentions occupation as ends, occupation as means, and the approach to the environment. This slide shows JOT's lifelong education system. As a whole, we aim to complete basic training within 5 years, achieve certification, and acquire specialization in 10 years. The vertical axis represents the type, and the horizontal axis represents the number of years.We ask Association Certified Occupational Therapists take role in junior training, management positions, and social roles. As of September 2021, 1,175 Association Certified Occupational Therapists have been trained. Another pillar is the development of human resources with academic knowledge and skills, called specialist occupational therapists. Areas are designated and trained according to occupational therapy expertise.
ここにその領域を指しますが、現在117名がその専門作業療法士の
人数。This slide shows the fields of specialist occupational therapist and the year of commencement. Until today, 117 specialists have been trained in 10 fields.JOT has established an examination system for the Association Certified and Specialist Occupational
Therapists. それではここからですね、2つ目のテーマであります生活行為向上マネジメントについてご紹介をしたいと思います。Management tool for daily life performance.
So far, I have explained the outline of JOT, training education, and lifelong training system. However, we are still facing many challenges.
At
this point, I will discuss the development process and achievement of MTD-LP. First, the practice of occupational therapy based on MTD-LP is a very ordinary occupational therapy. As previously mentioned, we got pointed out the medical and long-term care clinics where most Japanese occupational therapists work are conducting interventions that are biased toward improving mental and physical functions. So we needed to be aware that initiatives like this are a regression to the original form of occupational therapy.The flower on the upper left is the MTD-LP symbol, and each petal represents a different area of occupation. The period of 2008 to 2013 was the basic research phase to develop MTD-LP. During this time,We received a total of about 18 million yen from the National Research Grant and worked on research projects. We developed basic tools for MTD-LP, used them in clinical practice, and established a training system to disseminate it for their use. Since 2014, we have been working to incorporate this tool.Into the activities of JOT. Since 2015, we have been entrusted with a national research project to carry out training for the dissemination of the verification effects of MTD-LP by further expanding its application. As a result, Lifestyle Improvement Rehabilitation Addition was established in the long-term care field in 2015. Furthermore, the interest checklist, which was a product of research project, was incorporated as an evaluation tool for long-term care insurance.And is now used nationwide. In addition, when long-term care fees were revised in 2021, there was a proposal to abolish the addition due to the low performance. However, based on the results of the research by JOT, the addition remains and the requirements have been eased.Allowing the extensive provision of services. We also presented the initiatives that use MTD-LP for independent support and prevention of serious conditions, which greatly contributed to the creation of items related to activities, participation, and independent support. Through these activities, many medical and long-term care professionals have become increasingly aware that the role of occupational therapy lies in activities and participation.
心身機能に偏っても含めますが、作業療法がどういう仕事であるかということを多くの関連団体、国の関係者も理解してくれるようになっております。今後までやらせていきますと、MTD-LP の特徴は、
Now, I'd like to introduce MTD-LP. The characteristics of MTD-LP are, this is a support based on the PDCA cycle, is client-centered, has a structure based on the ICF, it allows sharing information with clients in setting goals, plans, and practices, and also is specific.
これがそのツールです。書式1、書式2、書式3。書式3はアセスメント表とプログラム表からなります。書式1は生活行為聞き取り表。これで目標、利用者のニーズを引き出します。
I will introduce the basic tools of MTD-LP.
若い世代は、
For details, please refer to the English version posted on the JOT website. Document 1 is a daily life performance interview. It's used to share realistic and concrete goals with clients. In addition, it also allows the comparison of the degree of execution and the degree of satisfaction with the goal.The hobbies and interest checklist of document 2 is a sheet for sharing the life history of the client and sharing what they are doing, what they want to do, and what they have an interest in. And it consists of 25 questions.This form can be used by relatively inexperienced occupational therapists too. Document 3 is a course sheet of MTDLP and is a management sheet for improving living activities. In this, we describe specific goals, factors that hinder the goals,strengths, and prognosis prediction. When completing the form, filling according to the ICF category. The lower part of document 3 is a program entry sheet. The next slide shows a specific example.
この目標が達成するために行うかということを書くようになっております。これがその上のアセスメント表であります。工程分析は企画力、実行力、検証力に分けまして、ここに基本プログラム、応用的プログラム、社会的プログラム、あ、申し訳ありません。これはプログラム表でありました。
This slide shows an example.For example, when client's goal is watering the fields next to my house and harvesting vegetables, a performance assessment is conducted, identified programs to achieve the goals based on the ICF category, and clarifying the when, where, who, and what to do.
これを見ますと、利用者の方、家族が、何をしたくて、それぞれのスタッフがどういうふうな支援をしてくれるんだということが分かるようになるようになっております。これからですね、これを活用した実践事例をいくつかご説明をいたします。
I would like to talk about our initiatives that utilize MTDLP. This slide shows the results of intervention of 52 clients living at their home who had problems with IADL. Difficult factors include mental and physical function, use of tools and environment, and interventions were performed accordingly.As a result, achievement and partial achievement were 83%. Since there is no control group, effectiveness cannot be proven. But the evidence was that the average visit period was 8 weeks. The average number of visits was 4.1. And in terms of frequency, once was 43%, and 2 to 3 times was 46%.
でここで注目していただきたいのが、その訪問期間であります。平均8週間であります。
This project is positioned as a community activity support type C project conducted by the local government.But since the project is usually set twice a week for 3 months, intervention by MTDLP can be said to be efficient and effective.
極めて、少ない回数で目標が達成できるということが明らかになりました。で次にご報告いたしますのは、重度者の方です。長期療養の施設にいらっしゃる方です。寝たきりの方であります。こういう方を評価しまして、
This slide is an example of the use of MTDLP for the purpose of supporting the independence, activities, and participation of severely ill people. Bedridden people in long-term care facilities are managed using MTDLP. And with the cooperation of doctors, nurses, and caregivers,They are encouraged to get out of bed and regain their activities. Although their life is limited inside the facility, they have regained an autonomous lifestyle. Following this, patients explain their desire to spend the night outside of the facility. The intervention was carried out with the goal of returning the client home.
先ほど言いました福祉用具を
The more activities an individual is able to do, the more their needs will grow. As such, we realize that the program needs to change constantly. Occupational therapists provide support for sitting, transferring, maintaining a sitting position, using transfer equipment for activitesIn a sitting position, selecting and adapting to a wheelchair, educating how to use it, and selecting activities in a sitting position.
ということも可能になるようになりました。このようなアプローチをしていなかったらですね、実はこの方は残念なことながら寝たきりだったというふうに思います。あと一事例お話しいたします。AS の方です。呼吸困難になりですね、病院でケアを受け、人工呼吸器をつけですね。
This slide shows a person with ALS who lives on a ventilator and wheelchair in the hospital.
なる前に、
The occupational therapist listened to what he wanted to do and with the support of doctors, nurses,and volunteer facility staff. The client was successfully discharged home and is now working as a volunteer at the facility as shown in the photo. This photo suggests so many things. First, the medical staff shouldn't restrict activities and participation depending on the degree of disability.They must present the activities and the possibility of participation and let the client choose. Since daily care is provided by the family, our role is to establish a well-organized hospitalization care system, including care for family members, improve the care skills of supporters, eliminate any anxiety,Respond to emergencies at home and utilize effective informal services. As mentioned before, MTDLP promotes activities and participation, learning to live a life in their own way and applying what they learn to their life.Adaptation and limitations of MTDLP need to be examined, but at the very least, I'm confident that we will be able to break away from medical paternalism. This slide shows the examination of changes in health-related quality of life of 230 clients in the MTDLP intervention and non-intervention groups over a year.These results are expected since the system allows clients to take the initiative in intervention and evaluate the results. In the future, it will be designated as one of the study areas of JOT to advance organizational research with the aim of utilizing MTDLP in the areas of mental disorders, developmental disorders,and also in other multidiscipline.
約 42%、これは昨年の5月1日で、今年の5月1日のデータでありますが、25,646
The slide shows the training system and its achievements to promote MTDLP. As for on-campus education, there are 17 cooperating schools, most of which have practiced its concepts and case studies, and have been given questions in the national examination for students.
さらに指導者を養成しようということで事例報告をペーパーで出しまして、それを合格した人を指導者として認定をしております。スライド
Finally, Japanese occupational therapy is practiced with a combination of ICIDH and ICF model. However, in the world of occupational therapy,We are in a good environment that allows us to produce the basics, clinical and research results of occupational therapy in medical treatment. In some facilities, doctors have recognized the effectiveness of occupational therapy in the hyperacute phase, such as the role of ICU, CCU, and brain surgery in the operating room.And employment of therapists is progressing. I think the important thing is to stay close to the client's situation and to promote their growth, help them realize their occupation, and to perform it. If people do not move based on the value of occupational therapy,The application of the therapy will remain limited. With that in mind, clients who have realized their occupation, they can live a truly brilliant life. Taking this into account, I'm convinced that a life with the occupation guarantees health and happiness.Occupational therapy in Japan was institutionalized 20 years after the war. Overcoming hardship, such as food shortages and infectious diseases after World War II. For the next 10 years, with the support of WHO, the faculty members received support from the United States and Canada for about 10 years.In addition, the first occupational therapist studies abroad in the United States and planted the seeds of occupational therapy in Japan, which grew to this point. Once again, we would like to thank WHO and W4T for their support. Each country, including Asian countries,Has its own unique culture and challenges. However, in the process of ensuring the security of the country and further growth of occupational therapy, I think that all countries have the possibility to experience what Japan has gone through. We would be happy if we could share.Such experiences with you, including the opportunity like today, and grow together.
最後になりますが、2024年、一番初めにも言いましたが、第8回 APOTC のご紹介をしたいと思います。
Last but not least, let me promote the 8th APOTC in 2024.It'll be held from November 6 to 9, 2024, and the venue will be at Sapporo Convention Center in Hokkaido.
ということで実施させていただきます。さまざまなプログラムを用意しております。例年と同じように口述発表、
As shown in the table, それからさまざまな、We have planned various programs.
学生プログラムも企画しております。それから札幌市内にある病院施設等の見学も準備したいとおります。まあここに札幌があります。
札幌 is a place endowed with abundant nature, so you can enjoy a lot of natural food.
近くにさまざまな。
We look forward to your participation.
ぜひ。
Thank you again to the congress organizer for giving me the opportunity to speak today.I hope for the further development of APTO. Thank you for your attention.
の皆様に心より感謝を申し上げ、私の 講演とさせていただきます。どうもありがとうございました。
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for that. Thank you, Haruki Nakamura, for your keynote address. It's most inspiring, and I guess we are all looking forward to Sapporo 2024. We'd like to call on our audience to share their takeaway on what the Japanese Association of Occupational Therapists had just shared with us. Sir Anthony, would you like to begin?
Okay, sure, Louis. As always, no, I really learned a lot from the keynote. No, one of the things to consider is that Japan is one of the countries that could be a good model for the Philippines. My argument consistently is this. One, in terms of population, there are just 20 million above us. In terms of culture, respect for the community and the elderly, we all also have that. And in terms of service and nationalism, we also have that. So Japan, really, we really learn a lot from Japan. And it's amazing how they have 63,215 members. And hopefully we reach that stage, you know, after probably several decades. It's a dream. Just 20 million above us, or we're 20 million behind in terms of the population, but they have 63,215 occupational therapists. And our goal is just to have 5,000 by 2025. We have a lot to learn. You know? And basically in the keynote, the main takeaway is that I really appreciate the MTDLP. And I think the calling here, and perhaps it could be my focus after my presidency, is to have a national OT study. That is to actually to measure the effectiveness of OT across all age group. Perhaps we could start in the all predominant, in a predominant sample in our country, and then use consistently to develop tool that is collaborative. No, it's something that we could all organize, no, as a community. And then it's important that whatever the results of those study, it can show outcomes and results in a discourse that is appealing both to the community, to the political, legal, and financial and insurance system. I think that's one of really the main takeaway that I saw, no? And it's something that we could do. So thank you very much, Haruki, for sharing that information to us and to the delegates.
アンソニーさん、どうもありがとうございました。フィリピンと日本と、なんか同じツールで一緒に研究ができたらいいなと思いました。よろしくお願いします。ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much, Anthony. I thought that we could use the same tool and conduct the research in two countries, Philippines and Japan.
Thank you. That is highly appreciated. And it's a national study that we will endeavor. Thank you very much. And then use it to put further the effectiveness of occupational therapy out for our especially to our politicians. Okay, because, appreciate it. Thank you.
Right. Thank you for that, Sir Anthony and Dr. Gresha. I'd also like to acknowledge some of the comments on the chat box because I think they really need to be acknowledged. Athena says, great job for the Japanese Association of Occupational Therapists in the management tool for daily living performance. I share the same sentiment. That's why I wanted to show it there. Gia says, arigato gozaimasu, Nakamura-sama. Ivan Gomez says he's looking forward to Sapporo in 2024. So Kyunji says long journey for good intention for people's participation of life. Thank you. J-A-O-T, Nakamura Kaicho. Someone says J-A-O-T is so cool and pretty cool. They are impressed with the development of MTDLP for use across Japan. I appreciate your sharing. They're looking forward to seeing you in 2024. We're looking forward to using your tool in the Philippines, by the way. Thank you. And I can't read that character, but I guess it's really good. Carla, can we go to questions and answers?
Thank you, Mr. Nakamura, for sharing JAOT's initiatives and evolving occupational therapy practice, which aims to promote human health and well-being, celebrating occupation and celebrating life, which is exactly the theme of our Congress today. To our audience, do you have any more questions? Please feel free. Any comments, just place that in the chat box.
There's one that's being asked from a direct message. It says, "What an inspiring speech. Thank you. May I ask how the Japanese Association of Occupational Therapists can attract a high membership percentage from practicing occupational therapists? Would you have any strategies to share?"
一つはやっぱり国の制度の中にで作業療法をしっかり価値づけてきたこと、それと国が認める作業療法のモデルを提示し、まあ、それを会員に開示したことだと思います。はい。
I think there are two things. One, we made good use of the Japanese government system, which positions OT as a valuable profession. And number two, we disclosed the model for OT presented by the Japanese government to the potential members. We made this part very clear.
All right. Thank you for that response. The next question for Nakamura-san is, so may I ask how do the occupational therapy respond to the requirement of specialized training and certification from Stella Cheng?
この制度を作って10年になりますが、協会がモデルを示して実施はですね、研修の実施は各都道府県市会で身近なところで研修ができるようにシステムを作っています。はい、それが一番大きなことだと思います。
It's been almost 10 years since we started this certification program.We clearly showed a JAOT model, and actual training programs are performed by the branch offices in each prefecture.
I guess this is the same question as the first one, was it?Or was there a confusion? I think this one was the one that wasn't answered. So for the keynote speech, may I ask whether the replay function would be retained? Okay, wait, hang on. I think this is for the organizers to respond to. My bad. All right.
Will we get the chat?
I think those are the questions for Mr. Nakamura.Are we all good? Would anyone else like to share their insights for or takeaways from the keynote address?
Reading from the chat, Louis, we completely agree with Patrick Kerr's sentiment. Thank you, Mr. Nakamura, for your sharing, your leadership in JAOT, and the work that you and your team are doing is truly impressive. And we share that same sentiment. Thank you. On that note, we would like to present Certificate of Appreciation to you, our speaker, the Philippine Academy of Occupational Therapists and Learning Ablers award the Certificate of Appreciation to Mr. Haruki Nakamura for sharing his invaluable knowledge as keynote speaker during the 7th Asia Pacific Occupational Therapy Congress hosted by the Philippines via AirMeet this 24th of November, 2021, signed by Roland Lyle Duque and Arcil Rosario Gozon, co-conveners, and Dr. Anthony Gresha, president of the Philippine Academy of Occupational Therapists. Thank you very much, Mr. Nakamura.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, we do apologize that certain that the certificate was not flashed, but hopefully you all know how it looks like from the past 4 days. We really do appreciate what Mr. Nakamura had shared with us, and we really look forward to Sapporo in 2024. So we will now be having a 45-minute break before we start with the concurrent sessions at 10:30. We'd also like to invite everyone to build their professional and collegial networks through the AirMeet Lounge, and to also visit the posters and sponsors at their booths. The lounge and the booth tabs may be found at the top of the AirMeet browser beside the schedule. We'd just also like to mention that lunch break will be at 12 noon, and there will be an announcement if there will be a luncheon presentation again. We would like to request the delegates to be back and settle in the platform by 12:50 for the start of our afternoon sessions.
We'll see you at the lounge, everyone.
Do we have a few more minutes to share in the plenary? I'd also like to mention just a little thing on the Philippine end. The University of the Philippines Manila Department of Occupational Therapy, in support of how the Philippine Academy of Occupational Therapists want to promote further education advancements in the education within the country, the department is hosting a needs assessment survey that we'd like to share with everyone. And so if Ms. Marcy Nanyagas of the department, Assistant Professor Nanyagas, can come forward and share her study with us, her needs assessment survey, tell us more about it. Ma'am Marcy, are you there? There she is.
So hello, good morning again, everyone. As Luis said, the department is conducting a study right now. And over the course of this conference, we've heard how the occupational therapy practices are continuously adapting and advancing. So in an effort to ensure that our educational programs, particularly our graduate level programs, are responsive to these changes, we are conducting a needs assessment study for a master's program. So you would like to invite all the Filipino occupational therapists present today to spend about 10 to 15 minutes of their day to offer their insights to this study that we're doing. So you may access the study through the link that I will be posting on the chat as well as the feed in a while. So we're looking forward to your participation for the Filipino occupational therapists, and thank you in advance.
All right. Thank you for that. And thank you, everyone, for indulging that little plug that we just did. It's for the advancement of the profession. And who knows where that will take us in the next few years. Okay, and so, Carla, are you ready to take a break?
I am. Are you? I shall see you at the lounge. Bring your
See you at the lounge,
virtual
everyone.
Coffee.
See you there.
Okay, I think, yeah, we'll go now to that. Check people. Okay, thank you.